looks like Didcot Railway Centre is not far ahead now. Time to get up anyway. Not far ahead now. The Didcot Railway Centre, home of a great Western society. So this is it. Our right destination. Oh, ah, that horn made me jump. The wagons and brick fans down there. Oh yes, the engine shed. Let's take a look in there. Caution, engines must not pass this arch. Goes that diesel again. Must be nearing to the shed, home of the Great Western Engines. Yeah. Rod 5322. Orny Prince Charlie, number one. This should be the basis of Percy, but not really. Shaggy. WTCL number 5. I heard I meant WC Company, WT Company. Oh shoot. I'll deal with you later. Philly Castle. Great look at the ancient shed, at least. Yup. Right now I'm outside the shed, which is right behind it. Back in the railway. And there are more sheds down there. As well as some track over there where it rides off a broad gauge engine. As they expect. Oh, yup. Is that a DMU? Yeah, this could be a DMU. That's strange. DMU has a whistle. Oh, this. I'm not sure if it's a DMU because it has a moving piston draw. Oh my goodness, that seems a bit strange. A DMU has it's a steam engine? You know, because it has pistons, cylinders, it moves. I don't know. But I could be wrong. Again. Never mind. Wow, what a shot. 6016 speed, tornado, in a much different Livery as I aware of it, but it is pretty nice. I mean, it's British Railway Livery colour, don't you agree? Not strange having this wagon here, but expected as a glass carrier or something, I don't know. This is not much like a sort of steamworks turntable, you know. All turntables are different, like this one, for instance. There's a broad cage engine over there, which is based on Iron Duke in Christopher Audrey's book, Thomas and the Great Railway Show.